Hello, hello, hello. Today is Wednesday, May 29, 2024. Solutions to problem 202. The mass of a spherical shell was given, and the thickness of the shell was the same everywhere. It was 30 kilometers. That is key, that the thickness is the same everywhere. A and B were easy, but C was the killer for many. Inside the spherical shell, the gravitational field is zero everywhere because the thickness of the shell is the same everywhere. If the wall of the shell had not been the same everywhere, or if it had not been a hollow sphere, for instance, a hollow cube, there would have been a gravitational field inside everywhere. 801. Now comes something that may still be a surprise to some of you. If it had been a charged conductor of any shape, the E field inside would have been zero everywhere, because the electric potential energy must be the same everywhere. 802. Apart from Kiesnorman and Eugen, who always have the answers correct, there were 9 more who had the correct answers. Not bad. And you see them here. This gentleman used Python solution, which is very interesting all by itself. Untouched by human hands, he got the right answers. So, if you're ready now, here comes Kiesnorman's solution of problem 202.
This is Keith's solution to Walter Lewin's problem 202. It concerns a hollow spherical shell, and we know its mass, we know its outer radius, and we know its thickness. So we can calculate from that, from the outer radius and the thickness, we all clearly know its inner radius, which I've called Ri. We're asked for part A to work out its density. Very easy. We need to take the outer volume minus the volume of the empty space inside. So usual formula for a sphere, 4/3 pi r cubed minus the inner one, and I get that in meters cubed. Now for part A we need to know the density, which is simply mass divided by the volume of the shell, which I've calculated. So that equation there gives me that answer in kilograms per meter cubed. Part B, we're asked to compare it with the density of water, this density here. Density of water is roughly 1,000 kilograms per meter cubed. Possibly a little bit less. So essentially I've used the 1,000 kilograms per meter cubed, and I get that. So relative density, roughly 84. And the final part, what's the gravitational force on this mass? It's zero. One of the effects of the inverse square law is that because we have a uniform shell, you should have seen this in previous problems where we considered the gravitational force and the gravitational potential, how it varied as we approached the centre of the Earth and it dropped off linearly. The reason for that is a uniform shell has no internal gravitational field. I won't prove that here. It's a standard proof in the various textbooks. So part C is it's zero, and it doesn't matter where the mass is, how big the mass is. It could be right up on the edge here. It could be in the centre, obviously. It could be a tiny mass, a big mass. It's going to be zero. And that's the end of the problem. Except for me, it's not. Because I looked at this and I thought, that's very dense, relative density compared to water. So lead is about 11 relative density compared to water. Osmium, the densest naturally occurring element that we know of, is roughly 22. And that set me thinking, this is really a very dense shape. So I thought, what if that were a black hole? And literally, maybe it was that size and that thickness. You would have out here ludicrously high gravitational fields, so high that the light could not escape. And yet inside the hollow spherical shell, you would have no gravity at all. And I found that quite a fascinating concept. But maybe that's why I like physics. It just, you know, comes up with these little thoughts that we have from time to time, and that was one of them. Thank you.